Hey, good day, folks. Welcome to another episode of Andrew's Life. I will be driving through the city of Florence, Kentucky on this video, which is a suburb of Cincinnati, Ohio. It is 17 minutes south of Cincinnati. It is located in Boone County, Kentucky. The population here is 33,423 people. And this city has grown by 8.1% as of the 2020 census. Now, if you want to live in this city, the median home price will be $226,000. Which, by the way, if you're looking to live in this city, bear in mind that the housing market here is relatively competitive. I know when I looked on the realtor.com website for a house here in Florence, there were a bunch of houses that were contingent or pending. So I would say, as far as houses that are available, I would say the pickings are relatively slim at this point. Even when I began looking at houses in the $300,000 and $400,000 range, still the pickings were a bit slim. Now, if you're just looking to rent, your median rent prices will go from $588 to $1,355 a month. Now, as far as it goes for crime, your violent crime is 37.5% below the national average. And your property crime is 77% above the national average. So when it comes to the crime in this city, the crime is relatively low, as it is in many suburban communities. Now, as far as the city being a suburb of Cincinnati, I mean, as you drive through the city, at least as I drove through the city, there's definitely that suburban feel. And there's also a small city feel in this city, at least to me there is. Now, when I drove through the city, I honestly didn't see any part of the city to where I would be like, yeah, this is gonna be the quote unquote bad part of the city, so to speak. Now, there is a part of the city which you guys will see in a little bit here, to where, yes, the houses are going to be smaller, and you'll be able to tell that it's going to be the city's lower priced neighborhoods, if you will. But just by looking at the median home price of the city, when I say lower price, I bet a lower priced house here would probably run at least $120,000. I'm just picking numbers off the top of my head, just based off of the median home price here. But as I drive through even some of these lower priced neighborhoods, like I said, I don't see any area of this city that I would say that's bad. I mean, for the most part, this city is fairly clean, it's fairly well kept. And like many other suburban cities, you do have, you know, the city does have pretty decent amenities. And the majority of the communities here are, you know, the yards are well kept. You know, the majority of your houses are half decent. You're not going to find a whole bunch of ran down houses anywhere. You're not gonna find a bunch of people hanging out and doing things they shouldn't be doing. Now, maybe at nighttime that might be a little different, but at least during the daylight, I don't seem to see that. Now, as far as it goes for race, you got 85.6% white, 4.9% black, 2.3% Asian, and 5.3% Hispanic. And this is the second largest city in Northern Kentucky after Covington. With Covington, Kentucky, I didn't get a chance to do that city, but Covington is just right outside Cincinnati. And this is, of course, one of Kentucky's northernmost cities in the state of Kentucky. And this city is also the home of Florence Yaw's independent minor league baseball team, for those of you that are baseball fans. Now, a few major employers of Florence, I mean, obviously, for some of the bigger and better paying jobs, most people that live here drive into Cincinnati to go to work. But if you don't have a vehicle, or you don't want to do a bunch of driving, especially during the winter, because the winters here sometimes can get kind of, you know, I mean, the winters here aren't going to be as bad as, let's say, Cleveland or Toledo, but down here it does snow, and sometimes this region of the country does get ice storms. And given that this region of the Midwest is real hilly, I mean, around here, if you get snow and ice, it could be a bit of a challenge to drive through. So for those of you that don't want to have to drive real far to your job, I mean, some of your major employers in the city is St. Elizabeth Healthcare. So for those of you that have your nursing license, or maybe you're an MD, or for some of you that are blue collar, you know, maybe you might have your CNA license, or maybe you might want to work as a maintenance person or a custodian, you got the St. Elizabeth Healthcare Center. You also got Boone County Schools, which hires a fair amount of people. I mean, anywhere from your school teachers to custodians to probably some maintenance personnel. Then you got Eagle Manufacturing, which I didn't bother to look up to see specifically what they manufacture, but obviously it's a factory job. Then you got Walmart and Costco Wholesale, for those of you that don't mind working retail. And then some other companies that are large employers that are not in the city limits, but they're closer to the city is. You got Citigroup, you got Crane Composites, you got DRS Duro Bag Manufacturing, you got Kellogg's, and you got Kona Ice. And some interesting information about this city is, I mean, it is the home of Sean Alexander, which he was a former NFL football player. He played running back for the Seattle Seahawks and the Washington Redskins. And before he got signed on to the NFL, he got signed on in the NFL in 2000, but before then, when he was going to college, he played college football for the Alabama Crimson Tide. Now, as far as a few things to do here in Florence, obviously, if you want to get into the more exciting entertainment, obviously, you can just go 20 minutes north into Cincinnati. But if you don't want to drive into Cincinnati for whatever reason, as far as entertainment here, you got Ole's Skate Park. You got the Florence Mall. You got the Full Throttle Indoor Karting, which is basically a place where you can drive go-karts around, and they got other things to do, so it's kind of like an indoor amusement park. And for all of you that like to play golf, you got World of Golf. So, like I said a minute ago, if you're looking to live in the greater Cincinnati area, Florence, Kentucky would not be a bad alternative in my opinion. Now, there are a couple of places on the Ohio side, on the Ohio side, which I I did videos of a couple of places on the Ohio side, which I will be posting up here in the near future. But I will tell you right now, if you're looking to live somewhere with nice scenery, such as rolling hills, then you know definitely give this city a look. I mean, obviously for housing you will pay a little bit of money, but you know, then again, it is a suburb, so it's to kind of be expected. But I would say, all in all, this is not a bad place to live. I mean, you know, it appears to be a clean city. As you guys can see, there's plenty of amenities very close by. And most places are within walking distance. So if you live in the city and you don't own a vehicle, I mean, during the times of the year where there's no snow, you can always go somewhere and purchase a bicycle and ride a bike to work or ride a bike to wherever it is you gotta be. Or two, you can walk. And I'm not 100% sure about this, but I believe there is a transit system in this city. I'm not 100% sure. So for those of you that are familiar with this city, leave a comment below and let us all know whether or rather not there's a city transit that goes through this city. I think there is, though. Alright folks, that's going to be my commentary for this video. I'm going to let you guys enjoy the rest of the video. And as always, thanks for tuning in to another episode of Andrew's Life. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, consider doing that, because I will be dropping tons of videos from the trip that I took up north. I got tons of content, so you know, if you haven't subscribed, consider doing that. That way you'll get notification for every video that I drop. And as always, for those of you that have been interacting and leaving comments in the comment section, keep doing that, because I appreciate every last one of you. And until next time, y'all have a blessed one. And I will see you on the next one. that, Kitty. gotta sit down and eat.